गुड मॉर्निंग फ्रेंड्स, दिस इज जेपी यादव। इन लास्ट स्लाइड वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट कंस्ट्रक्शन ऑफ पीएन जंक्शन डायोड। टुडे आई विल डिस्कस अबाउट वर्किंग ऑफ पीएन जंक्शन डायोड। एट फर्स्ट, इफ पी एन एन सबस्ट्रेट आर डोपिंग ईच अदर, P substrate into N or N substrate into P, then we can design PN junction diode. Due to P and N, P have holes majority charge carrier and N have electrons majority charge carrier. When these substrate are doping to each other, then a depletion layer creates. What is depletion layer? Depletion layer is a region in a PN junction diode where no mobile charge carrier are present. Depletion layer act like a barrier, like a insulator, which opposes the flow of electrons and holes to each other. Like that, P have holes and N type have electrons. Then P and N are joined together, then holes attract electrons and electrons attract holes. They move each other. Electrons goes to P substrate and holes goes to N substrate. Then a layer, a barrier is present. Sigma P type substrate minus means electrons are present, and in N side plus means holes are present. This layer is called depletion layer. It behaves like a insulator. When this layer is present, then no charge carrier flow from P to N or N to P. Now we discuss working of PN junction diode. Junction diode have two terminals, P side positive, N side negative, and middle layer is depletion layer. Okay, positive and negative. We use DC battery. But the connection of DC battery between P and N side is two ways. We can connect P side positive or negative and N side positive or negative. The characteristics is understood by these, like a reverse bias PN junction diode. Reverse bias PN junction diode means P is positive, N is negative. If battery is connected opposite terminals, battery negative terminal is connected to P side and battery's positive terminal is connected to N side. P is negative, N is positive with battery biasing. Then the diode is called reverse bias condition. In reverse bias condition, a positive voltage is applied to the N-type material and negative voltage is applied to the P-type material. The positive voltage applied to the N-type material attracts electrons toward the positive electrode and away from the junction, while the holes in the P-type end are also attracted away from the junction towards the negative electrode. Due to this reverse biasing, a depletion layer width is increased. If we increase the potential of battery, then the depletion layer also increase. How? So let us see. The n side is positive and p side is connected with negative. This is called reverse biasing. P substrate have negative charge, p substrate have positive charge, but battery is negative to p side and battery is positive to n side. Then this battery repels more electrons to p side, and this battery from p side holds repels to n side. This region in depletion layer, n region have positive, p region have negative charge. When potential is increased, then this depletion layer also increase, because opposite charge is given by battery. Then if depletion layer is increased, then no charge carrier flow from P to N or N to P, and no current conduct in the diode. Only a leakage current is flow in reverse direction, because N side have minority charge carrier holes and P substrate have minority charge carrier electrons. These minority charge carrier flow and current is produced in microampere. Okay, like that. In reverse direction, only microampere and nanoampere current is flow. And after a peak point, if we increase potential of the battery, then the depletion is very large and battery heat up the diode and diode is burn or breakdown. If diode is breakdown, then the depletion layer charge is moves across the P to N or N to N, and large current is produced minus VZ. This is reverse breakdown region. This is harmful for the diode. This condition is not reachable for working of the diode. Now, forward bias of the diode. If we connect positive terminal with positive battery, negative terminal with negative terminal of battery, P side connected positive, N side connected with negative, this biasing is called forward biasing. Like that. N region is connected minus, P region is connected plus, this is called forward bias. Due to this, negative terminal is repels electrons and positive terminal repels holes. N side have electron, P side have holes, majority charge, then the depletion layer is reduced slowly. If we increase the potential of battery, then the depletion layer is ellipse at a 0.7 volt for silicon and 0.3 volt for germanium. This is because the negative voltage repels electrons toward the junction, giving them the energy to cross over and combine with the holes, being pushed in the opposite direction towards the junction by the positive voltage. This result in a characteristic curve of zero current flowing up to the voltage point, also called as knee point. This is 0.7. This is called knee point. At first, depletion layer is present, so only 0.1, 0.2, 0.3 points till up to 7.7 volt only small current is flow. After 0.7 volt, depletion layer is elapsed and the charge flow freely from P to N or N to P substrate and the current in flow diode. So simple, the characteristics of diode for ideal diode which have no resistance, it's called ideal diode. In reverse direction current is zero and in forward bias current is maximum at zero voltage. When we use battery, then the depletion layer is not present in ideal diode. Theoretically, we consider that diode have no depletion layer and current is increased suddenly when battery is connected. But in practical diode, the diode not conduct before 0.7 volt. After 0.7 volt, current is increased and reverse current is zero. This is the working of the diode. Now, the use of diode, where we use the diode? In electronic circuit like a rectifier, where we use conversion of AC voltage to DC voltage, clipping circuit, clamping circuit, protection circuit, logic gates and voltage multiplier. We will discuss these circuits in details in next slide. Thank you for